Good evening. He has sobbed that he is sorry and cannot forgive himself. But it can't change the dreadful reality of what happened when Brett Button got behind the wheel of a wedding bus in June last year. 10 lives were lost and many more destroyed in a case involving so much devastation. Button has now learned he'll be in his 80s before he's eligible for release.
For days, their grief has consumed a court, though their heartache will last forever.
I don't know about other people. They might find that this is a closure for them. But my niece was only 22. She had so many more years to live.
They knew, raised and loved Darcy Bullman, Rebecca Mullen, Zach Bray, couple Andrew Scott and Lennon Scott, Tori Cowburn, Angus Craig, mother and daughter Nadine McBride and Kaya McBride, and Kaya's partner Kane Simons. All 10 lives stolen in last year's horror bus crash at Greta. Their driver was painkiller dependent Brett Button. He'll now serve at least 24 years behind bars.
Addiction is a disease, I'll admit that. But no matter what, he was still responsible for all those lives.
It shows that they mattered.
Hours earlier, in a courtroom filled with those he's hurt most, a shaking Button wept, "I'm sorry, but how do you say you're sorry for such a horrible, tragic event that has ruined the lives of hundreds of people? I can't forgive myself. I hate myself. I never meant to hurt anyone in my entire life, and now I've committed the ultimate sin." Button admits he'd taken too much of opioid painkiller tramadol on the day of the tragedy. He'd also been going too fast. In the words of a district court judge of 21 years, "I've never dealt with, seen or even read about a case that involved anywhere near the same extent of extraordinary devastation." At one point, the judge interjected with his own questions about Button's understanding of why doctors were concerned about his use of tramadol, especially when driving. Button said he'd been using it for so long, he never felt affected by it. But the sentencing judge says Button abandoned his responsibility to his passengers, and for that he's been jailed for a maximum of 32 years.
We want people to remember them as the loving, kind, caring people that they were.
Alice Hogg for 10 News First.